very good morning to all of you and a very happy Guru Purnima to all our gurus, mentors of life and our teachers. So we just wish them, but do we know the meaning, the importance of the day, my dear friends? Let's see, why do we celebrate it? We celebrate it to pay tribute to our teachers, as in our daily routine we forget to thank them. Instead we get bored of them when they are teaching us something that we don't like. At times we back answer them, make their jokes, and make their funny sketches. But these days help us to know their value in our lives. But who started this day? Let me think.
Wait. Don't wash your brain so much. Friends always complete one another. You have given half of the knowledge and I will help you with the rest. According to the Hindu calendar, in India, this festival was celebrated on the full moon day, that is Purnima, in the month of Ashad. This festival was revived by Mahatma Gandhi to pay tribute to his spiritual guru, Srimad Rajchandra. On this day, devotees worship their spiritual gurus and visit temples to seek blessings.
But, acha, got it. But don't you think in today's generation, not only a teacher is a guru, but e-gadgets like phone and its apps like Google, social media awareness, Wikipedia, etc. are also teachers?
Yes, I agree. But as it is technology, so there is no one to keep check on kids all the time. They are misusing it. They also don't know their limitations either.
That's true, and definitely a fact to be highlighted, as it's also true that it has become applaudingly obvious that our technology has exceeded our humanity.
I agree that kids do not know their limitations. I can tell you with an experience of my friend had. So let me share it with you all so that you will be aware what harm can teachers without restrictions can do. In a small village, there was a very well-renowned school. Aditi and Rohit were the brightest senior students in the class, amongst the senior students. They used to study together and participate in other competitions too. They used to win awards and make their school proud. They both had keen interest in journalism. They used to share ideas in the class of various ideas in daily. Every time they used to score highest in the class. So their father gifted them mobile phones.
Take this phone and work harder next time. Same was done by Rohit's father.
Their friendship was too strong. But due to their new mobile phone, they were getting diverted and spending more time on Google, WhatsApp, Facebook, etc. Staying active on social media for a long affected Aditi's studies. Rohit started failing in his sports and so he had to drop playing football.
Rohit, you could score that goal, but you didn't. Where is your discipline? Your body is also seeming to be unfit. What is wrong with you?
Sorry sir, I know where I have gone wrong. Definitely I will rectify my mistake and also sleep on time. Using techniques given by you in game and no extra online techniques, as just they give half knowledge. And also I will sleep on time.
Rohit and Aditi met one day in park to cycle.
Hey Rohit, you look sleepy.
Yes, The group chat was buzzing all day long with unwanted texts.
My phone was buzzing too, and I had to keep it on silent. I woke up to about 100 messages in the morning.
Yes, we must do something about it, as we are not only missing our guru, we are also breaking our parents' trust.
Pay less attention to my studies and more attention to my phone. We must do something about this.
From that evening onwards, Aditi and Rohit started analyzing their mobile phone usage in a day and got to know that their mobile phone usage was no less than 8 hours in a day. They started putting their mobile phone on silent mode for 4 hours a week day. Also, they started conversing less on group chats and started putting their mobile phone on switch off mode each day, every day, a week.
Some criticized, some applauded, but they were firm that they would use social media intelligently. After some days, Rohit persuaded the football team and won the competition. And Aditi also persuaded her hidden passion and started writing short stories and poems. Seeing their habits, their friends also started following them, and a general knowledge group was made to share news and to discuss on topics. Also, a doubt solving group was made where discussion would help them to study more.
Alright then, from now onwards we will use social media intelligently.
Then they started working for society for creating social awareness. On annual day, when they were asked to speak something, they said,
"Google is a teacher, but we cannot learn from it as we do cut, copy and paste."
True, Google is a media for us to learn, not an online guru to cut, copy and paste. So we should be stopped. So as we misuse it, we should be stopping to do it. Rather, we should listen to our parents and teachers and use it wisely. We use social media intelligently. What about you?